Last topic of the day, I had to talk about name.
The one on the right.
Because Diwali, as he says, around the corner, I thought just give a few pointers regarding the management of the funds. Actually, sir, I talked about it, you wanted this topic. When I say crackers, when we went to US, people were surprised, so they use crackers for biscuits here. So it's fireworks actually in the India. So when I presented this paper in a more better way, so they said they were surprised because that was something to do with biscuits. So etiology, when we went to, I have just retired from, as I told you, from the KMC Burns Department. We found that the maximum burns occur due to flower pots burns. They either burst or they didn't burn, or during the burning story the children went nearer. So the maximum accidents are due to flower pots. And the burning of powder is next. So 10 days before Deepavali and 10 days after Deepavali, we start getting the incidental burns, accidental burns. And these children, you know, they collect all the unburnt crackers and then put the powder in it and burn it. So that causes more burns than the actual crackers themselves. So in children, we found that if a children is below 12 years in our setup, not 18 like the American setup, so their male preponderance is seen because they are the ones who are more adventurous most probably. And the most affected areas are face and hands. In the elderly, the deepam burns because their sari gets caught with the lamps are lit and kept on the staircase. And these ladies, it's common in females because the saris are swooping, the pallu is swooping. And it affects the lower limbs because they do not disrobe immediately because of the inhibitions. And they use their upper hand limbs, you know, to put it out. So they get burned quite deeply when they come close. So cracker burns, if you see, all these children have the facial burns, typical of powder burns. And that last boy, I couldn't get a separate photograph of that fellow. He had it to the thigh because he put the crackers in his pocket, trouser pocket. So these are the demons, the labs which look quite nice, but they can cause burns on the lower limbs like this. Here the problem is they are all elderly women and they have comorbidities. So it becomes quite difficult. Actually, when the age increases, the mortality is 6 times more, the same percentage, when you have the same percentage of burns. So we have to fight it out. So what do? Prevention is the motto of the day. Educate the public, motivate the children. Actually, nowadays children motivate us. We see some children do not want to buy firecrackers. They say, Vandama, Devaila. So that sort of motivation is from the children. And campaign, we used to go to the schools. We start them young. We tell the children, they carry to their parents and spreads like that. So talk to everybody who comes regarding the safety of using these firecrackers. So what is the first aid? First, remove the person from the area of the incident because more than the burns, it is the smoke which kills them. When the children, the patient has inhalational burns, the ratio of death is increased 5 to 6 times for the same given percentage age group of the patient. So remove them because not the smoke alone, it's the thermal burns of the upper respiratory tract and the noxious toxic agents which go into it. And loosen the garments or cut them off. Sometimes the gloves are so tight, we cut them off. And third dictum is wash with water, 100%. Please wash with water and not with cold water. We don't want ice cubes which will constrict the capillaries. Just clean water and no inks. I always tell this any group I go because I find, especially in the 24-hour clinic, the doctors when they come, they pour ink or gentian melt or something on the wound to cover it, send to us immediately. That it doesn't wash off at all. It takes days to wash them off because we're giving bath. We're unable to find out if the depth or the percentage or body surface area is affected. And more is infected. This causes infection of the wound also. So just to put the fact that pouring water helps. Why it helps? Nowadays, if everything is, you have got to give, it's not experience alone, but you've got some evidence-based medicines has to be practiced. So we went through the literature, it says the water cools 23 times faster than the air. That's the motto between putting water on the wound. It decreases pain, it stabilizes the mast cells, and because the mast cells stabilize, no histamine is released, so itching is reduced, and edema is reduced. So this is the evidence which says use water. So just to recap, you know, because it might be a long time, the skin has an epidermis. Epidermis all those corneum, stratum corneum to the basin. And the burns can involve the epidermis and the dermis. And you know a superficial dermis, superficial deep, and the whole of dermis is burnt, you get the full thickness burns. So how do you differentiate when it comes to us? Like anybody can get in the OP before it's referred to us. You get the erythema alone, like you get in your cooking at home, you get this erythema alone, it is first degree burns. It has excruciating pain, but it heals spontaneously with just now infection. And in second degree burns can be superficial deep. I will not go into detail, but if you have blebs, you know it's second degree. It's like about 2 to 3 days to heal if there's no infection. If it gets infected, it can become deeper. And same here, different degrees of burns. The second degree, we have a super deep second degree burns. And third degree burns, when the whole of the dermis is burnt, and the patient is absolutely anesthetic, no pain, where the nerve endings are burnt. So when you get a 100% burn chart, the patient is conscious, talking well, eating well, sitting up, and if you tell the relatives that the patient is going to die soon, nobody's going to believe that. So epidermal burns, the lady got from the cooker steam. Actually, steam burns are more dangerous because they carry the latent heat. So they've got about 4,000 times more heat than the normal hot water. And superficial burns with the blebs and two deep burns, these I put it because the marbling is the common one in deep burns. So minor burns, if the burns not involve hands, face, cranium and lower limbs, I didn't put that. They can be called minor burns. Less than 10% burns in children, 20% in adults. They can be treated as outpatients. You give them tetanus, dress the wound, ask them to give drink lots of water and send them home. Major burns, more than 20% of burns or less than 20% burns which involves face, hands and perineum and lower limbs, please admit. Because they need intravenous fluids to keep to make up the loss, and they need critical monitoring. And if specialized burn units are available, then it will. So main mantra is to control the infection. That's why I said clean water to wash the wound. And hand washing by caregivers, may it be doctors or physiotherapists or the nurses or the caretaker of the patient. So if they wash their hand with soap and water regularly, you can curtail the infection. Appropriate antibiotics only after culture and sensitivity, because the wound is sterile to begin with. 48 hours you send a culture, it will come as nil growth because the wound is sterile. But later on the nurse or the infection or the infection of the skin takes over. And we advocate bath for all the patients. The patient comes to you, ask them to clean the wound with water and then go come for dressings. It's very simple, apply SSD ointment, antimicrobial. And if it is hand-held, comfortable to give a closed dressing. You give them an open, you say, okay, let's put this ointment, not happy. But in those cases, you can apply a circumferential dressing. So silver sulfur diazide is still used, but not after 5 to 7 days because it interferes with epithelializing. And EGF fibril growth is very expensive, so nowadays we're going for nano silver because it is less expensive and better than the silver sulfur diazide. It has both silver sulfur diazide with the silver. So you can see that the wound is sufficient to apply silver sulfur diazide. The wound heals within 7 to 14 days. And now we have biological membranes. Amniotic membrane is still being used. Now if you're scared of HIV, now we can take it from the caesarean section. It's sterile and HIV is proved that it's HIV negative. And all this collagen, different types of collagen. So this is collagen, a wound for us because in a child, when a baby comes to us, a child, wash the wound, put the collagen, send the child home. The child can play, do whatever they want to do. And it just peels off once the wound is epithelized. See the happiness on the face, we don't have to keep the child with the dressing every day. The agony for the child and for the doctors, everything is cut short. So amniotic membrane, this was from an old photograph and we're still using it before the collagen came in. It was the cheapest dressing available. And inhalation burns, do not always get the one like this, the last one. Sometimes you get minimal facial burns also. As I said, please be on lookout for inhalation burns or signs and symptoms of inhalation burns. Sometimes the face is clear, the patient is burnt below the neck. So how do you rule out inhalation burns? Look for singeing of the hair or the replacing in the nose, watering of eyes, cough, hoarseness of voice, and ronchi and carburetor scooter. Then comes the blistering, as I said in the second degree burns. We do not break the blisters open. You can aspirate the blisters with sterile needle. What happens is the fluid is removed. So the cytokines are removed. It's not, as you know, the putrescent fluid is a good culture media. So you remove it off, leave the roof, do not de-roof it, and put a dressing and send the patient home. That will act as a biological dressing. Now we have our armamentarium, SSG, after some time when the wound deteriorates. And this lady I had to put, because I said preponderance of children in the male children. But this lady had to use a flower pot. She was carrying it in the hand, unburnt, and she resulted in this. She lost one finger. So I wish all of them, all of you happy and safe Diwali. So it was helping you some day.
Any questions? Thank you, madam. Please stay. Then you can Dr. Shanti, Vice President, to hand over the certificate of appreciation.